Hello students, in this video we will study the economic importance of cnidaria. See, this most of the cnidarians, they are the predaceous, but many of them they shows the friendly relationship with the other animals which are present in the habitat where the cnidarian lives. And when they shows the friendly relationship, these animals, they are also used as a food material. Okay, so there are many different types of the relations which are exhibited by the animals from the phylum Cnidaria. So the first relationship we will study, that is the commensal relation. See, in case of the commensal relation, there is a mutual beneficial relationship. Means both of them, they get benefited from each other. Okay, benefited from each other. म्हणजे थोडक्यात काय, तर दोघं एकमेकांना यूजफुल असतात. ओके, सो द म्युच्युअल बेनिफिशियल पार्टनरशिप इज देअर. अँड the example of this Hydractinia, okay, and the gastropod shell, or we can say that the hermit crab. Okay, so the shell of the gastropoda. So here what happens, see, the Hydractinia, which is the example of the Cnidaria, and it shows the beneficial relationship with the gastropod. Okay, so here what happens, see, the sea anemone, which are often carried out on the shells and shells of the hermit crab, as well as carapace and shells of the snails, means not only the gastropod but the crabs are also there, and they shows the relation, a good relationship between each other. So these animals, they shows the partnership, and they, in that partnership, both the partners, they get benefit from each other. So if the hermit crab is there, this hermit crab and the sea anemone, which is the example of cnidarian. So when both hermit crab and sea anemone, they lived together, this hermit crab carry the sea anemone, means hermit crab carry the sea anemones around their pincers. And these crabs, actually, they acquires the immunity to the poison of the sea anemone. How they get the, or how they acquire the immunity? So they acquire the immunity by feeding on the tentacles of the sea anemone. So the hermit crab acquires the immunity to the poison of the sea anemone. Now these crabs, when they carry the sea anemones around their pinners, sometimes when the remaining other animals of the aquatic habitat, when they attack on the hermit crab, and already the hermit crab carry the sea anemone, at that time what happens, see, the crab, they just use the sea anemone as the organ of offense and defense, because these sea anemone, they possesses poison, or they आर एबल टू प्रोड्यूस द पॉइजन. मग थोडक्यात काय की जर आपण बघितलं तर हा हर्मिट क्रॅब आणि सी ॲनिमोन हे दोघं एकत्र राहतात. सी ॲनिमोनला हा हर्मिट क्रॅब त्याच्या बॉडीवर राहू देतो आणि त्याबदली हा सी ॲनिमोन हर्मिट क्रॅबचं प्रोटेक्शन करतो. सिम्पली बोथ ऑफ देम दे आर यूजफुल टू इच अदर. देन द सेकंड एक्झाम्पल इज देअर. इन धिस सेकंड एक्झाम्पल the fish is there, and the fish Vamas is there, and the another Portuguese man of war, okay, or we also call it as the Physalia. Okay, see this fish of Physalia, which lived in a commensalism. Now, when this fish lived near the Physalia, they swim harmlessly. Means these fishes, they swims in the in between the tentacles of the Physalia, and the fishes feeds on the material which is just refused by the Physalia, and the fish developed the immunity to the hypnotoxin of these Physalia tentacles, and the fish get protection from the enemy because it lives in the in between the tentacles of the Physalia. So the enemies, they are not attacked, they are not dare to attack on the fishes, as the fishes get protected by the Physalia. And in return, fish help the Physalia by eating the food material which is get refused by the Physalia. So in this way, both of them, they are beneficial to each other. And see, this is the example of the commensalism. So the second one, symbiotic relation. See here, the zooxanthellae and the dinoflagellates, they lived in the intracellular symbiotic in the gastrodermal cells of different types of the cylindrate. Already we studied that the cylindrates, they shows the organs, different organs, and in that the gastrodermal cells are there. So the gastrodermal cells of cylindrates, they are act as the habitat for the dinoflagellates as well as zooxanthellae. Okay, so here both of them, they lived in the gastrodermal cells of the cylindrate. Okay, so these algal cells, they produce as the oxygen during the daytime, and we know that the oxygen is produced by these algae or algal cells. These algae, they follow the process of photosynthesis, and we know that during the process of photosynthesis, CO2 is utilized during daytime. CO2 is utilized and O2 is become free. So during daytime, when the process of photosynthesis takes place by these algae, the oxygen is released, and that oxygen is utilized by the cylindrate. And the metabolic waste of the cylindrate, that is used by the algae. Okay, in return, the cylindrate gets the oxygen and the nourishment produces by the, sorry, the nutrients which are produced by the alga. Okay, so here the cylindrate, they get benefited by the process of, by the algae, due to the process of photosynthesis which is followed by them. Okay, so this is about symbiotic relationship, where the cylindrate get benefited, but the algae, which is not suffer from any type of harm from the cylindrate. Okay, so this is about the symbiotic relationship of algae and cylindrate. Then the third one, that is the parasitic relations. Here what happens, see, parasitic, the name itself indicate. Okay, one is get benefited and another is sufferer. So in some snails, they suck the juice from the coral polyps. Okay, so these coral polyps provide juice to some of the snails. And since these snails, they are act as a parasite and they feed on the tissues of soft corals. Means the coral polyps, they are act as the host in this example, and snails are known as a parasite. So here we call it as a parasitic relationship. Then the fourth type of the relationship is there, we called it as the predatory relations. So here what happened, the cylindrates, okay, or we also call them as the nidaria, which are carnivorous. Carnivorous means what? Which feeds on the different types of animals. म्हणजे ॲनिमल्सला खाणारे, आपण ज्याला मराठीमध्ये शुद्ध मराठीमध्ये मांसाहारी म्हणतो. सो दीज निडारिया आर द कार्निवोरस अँड दे फीड्स ऑन डिफरंट प्लँक्टॉनिक ॲनिमल्स. दे कॅप्चर द प्रे विथ द हेल्प ऑफ देअर टेंटॅकल्स, बिकॉज वी नो दॅट द निडारिया पजेसेस द टेंटॅकल्स. अँड दीज टेंटॅकल्स आर हेल्पफुल फॉर कॅप्चरिंग द food material. Okay, food capturing is the process which is takes place by the tentacles. And since we are saying that these animals, they show the predator relationship, and many of the cylindrates, they are consumed by the other predatory animals also. Okay, so all these are the four different types of the relationships with the nidaria and the other animals which are present in the same habitat. Now, the nidaria, they also shows the relation to or with the man. So now we are going to study the relation of cylindrates to man. Means we are not aquatic, but here whatever the four different types of the relationship we study, in that the animals are aquatic. Here we are not aquatic, but since there is a relationship between the cylindrate and the human being, we used them as a food material. Okay, so the jellyfishes and the sea anemone, which are the example, and these fishes are, sorry, jellyfishes and the sea anemones, they are act as a food. Okay, and they are used as a food in very few countries. Means man feed on this material. Then secondly, they are the stingers. See, when we use the cylindrate as a food, it is good. Means it is positive that we are using the cylindrate. But actually, stingers, these cylindrates, they are act as a stingers, because many of the cylindrates, they directly attack or they affect the human being by stinging the human being with the help of the nematocysts. So these nematocysts or the sting cells, they have the ability to pierce the human skin. Okay, and they directly attack on the human being. For example, hydrozoa and the scyphozoa, since we call them as the stingers, and they causes a deep wound. And the divers, okay, divers, ज्याला आपण गोताखोर म्हणतो ना, म्हणजे समुद्रात खूप खोलवर जातात ते वेगवेगळ्या कारणांसाठी, मग त्यांना आपण डायव्हर्स म्हणतो. सो द डायव्हर्स, दे गेट डीप वुंड बाय द स्टिंग ऑफ दीज सिलेंट्रेट्स, अँड द टॉक्सिक मटेरियल इज ऑल्सो रिलीजेस बाय द cylindrate. So they are act as the stingers. It is not good for the human being. Okay, then third one, the corals. Now this coral is beneficial, but the inflict painful sting, and sometimes they cut the skin of the bathers. And since the coral rocks or its island, though they are useful as a military bases, and they are also useful as a landing fields. These corals were favorable sites for the accumulation of the petroleum deposits. Means if the presence of the coral reefs are there, we can say that the petroleum must be get deposited in that particular area. So the hard coral line can be used for building purpose, as well as we can use that corals as a decorative material. So this is about the use of coral. Okay, so this is the beneficial one. So corals are beneficiary to the human being. Then we are also use the different types of animals of Coelenterata for the purpose of decoration. Already we said that the corals which are already, we said the corals are used as a decorative material. So here separately, if you just study the decorative material, we are using the red corals, and we are using those red corals for the attractive, making the attractive jewelry. Then in case of the indoor aquarium, we are used the rock gardens, and which is prepared by the corals. Some of the corals and the sea pens which are frequently displayed as a ornament. So here we are using the animals from Coelenterata for the decorative purpose. Then the final and the important one as the experimental, we are used that material or animals in experimental biology. So Coelenterates are the animals, we use them for the process of demonstration of some biological terminologies or some biological phenomenon. For example, we know the budding process of budding. Budding, hydrala chota sa ek bud yeta. Okay, so we call it as a budding. But the process, budding chi process kashi hota ki va bud kasa tayar hota, he apan tyachyamadhye study karto. We also study the process of regeneration. We study the colony formation, polymorphism, then how these animals, they shows the behavior. So all these type of the phenomenon we study here in the Coelenterates. We also use these animals in research as well as in the experimental biology in our laboratory. And since we are just use these animals from Coelenterata as a biological material. Okay, like this way, the Cnidaria, animals from Cnidaria, or the animals from Coelenterates, they are useful to us, as well as some of them they are harmful to us. For example, the animals which are stingers, they are harmful to us. Okay, so all this is about the economic importance of the Cnidaria. Thank you.